I've always wanted to develop games. In summer 2019, I got inspired by some game development videos on YouTube. I wanted to make something similar, but I had no idea about how game development worked. The first time I managed to get a game work was using Construct Free Trial. But very soon I understood that not only was it very limited, but extremely uncomfortable to use. That is when I installed Unity and started learning C#. I found it more useful indeed, and started my journey by creating some ugly looking games. My first one was a continuation of a prototype I made in Construct. Earlier, I tried to make it using vector graphics, but very soon I saw that I couldn't draw. I started looking for a collaboration. Surprisingly, many people applied for one, and they decided to work together with each other. But I did not understand how a team worked. I let anyone be in the team, which was full of unorganized newbies, like me. We worked on a game for months, even though it was nothing big. The main point of the game was being as hard as possible. Looking back at it, I can understand how bad it was, but I'm still proud of it being my first game ever. It had surely been a progress of finding out something about the engine and how it worked. We wanted to release the game on Google Play, which never happened. I got a Google Play developer account, but it was when the team was already falling apart. The game was a failure, but the experience was a success. My second game did not get as close to finished as my first one did. When I was following a rollerball tutorial, I decided to turn it into something fun. I tried adding some more options, skins, and the point to the game. I had a Discord server with about 40 people following my creations that time. The game worked fine on my computer, but it turned out very unoptimized on mobile phones. The problem is, I published it and didn't test it. I had to urgently stop the project creation because I did not know how to optimize games then. That's how I learned a lesson. Always test before publishing. For the following birthday, I bought myself a modern computer, which I could finally use to create what I wanted. By that time, I had long had an idea of creating my second Russian YouTube channel, about programming. I started it by making Python bot tutorials, but in a couple of months, it turned just into a game development channel. My next game was started as a challenge of creating a game in 30 minutes. It was a simple gameplay, but I got a couple of hundreds of views, and some comments supported me and asking me to continue. So I shortly after released a new video. This one was continuing to make the game in 3 hours. By that time, I managed to get money system, shop system, menu system, and skin system done. And that had gotten 100 views more. That encouraged me even more. So in the next video, I finished it and published it to Google Play. This turned out to be my first finished and published game ever. I've even made my own trailer for it. Take a look.
Резедескер представляет Ghosty the Runner.
And the next video of the game creation turned out really well. A YouTuber whom I knew and whom I watched, came to my Discord server and asked if I wanted to participate in a game jam with him and some other YouTubers. He had 3,000 subscribers at that time, and I had just 200. I could not even imagine he would talk to me. I asked him to prove if it was really him.
What?
He was a bit astonished. What? So finally, we made a small 2-day game jam. We worked in 2 teams, 3 people in each team. Then everyone made a video about this creation. And there was a rating about which team's game is better. Spoiler, my team won. That collaboration instantly brought me some new subscribers, but it didn't end on that. The video became more and more popular, and now it has over 300,000 views. This video brought me many new subscribers and brought lots of other videos to the audience. My channel has currently got 16,000 subscribers. My next two videos have also been a little of a hit. They both got more than 100,000 views. In the first one, I also participated in a two-day game jam, but this time on my own. It was a game about moon rotating around Earth and hitting asteroids which want to destroy this Earth. This game, unlike the last one, was published to Google Play and became my most downloaded project. I made some more games. Not all of them were finished or published, but most of them were fun. One game was called Strangest Game Ever and was made from random ideas of my subscribers. Just imagine marinated cabbage, fighting with mushrooms, jumping from island to island and collecting pigeons. My last finished game is my favorite. It's called Oink Defense, and it's about a pig fighting with acorns. The pig needs to run away from them and set up traps. You collect coins to buy skins. In this game, I worked with an artist. That's why it looks so cool. The game is published in Google Play. The game was cool, but it had no goal, and we kind of forgot about it for a couple of months. And just now I want to do something new in it, and I want to add translation to this game. For example, it has no English translation yet. But then I had an idea crisis. I just could not imagine what else to make a video about. I made a couple, but they were quite bad because I did not really put much effort into them. And that crisis had been with me for about 5 months. And just when I seemed to get new ideas and motivation for my videos, war in Ukraine started. And because I'm from Ukraine, I had to flee to my relatives in Austria. So I'm living here now, and just about 2 weeks ago, I got a laptop and bought a microphone the day before yesterday. There's no returning to Russian YouTube for me now, but I've always wanted to be a YouTuber. So I created this English YouTube channel. I'll be posting about my game development experience here. I have not yet earned cents on my games, but I hope I will in the future. I have a long road in front of me, and I'm expecting to face it with you.